Hey, all you shooting fans. We are here in beautiful Nicosia, Cyprus, where we're kicking off the third leg of the 2013 ISSF World Cup in Shotgun. Over 380 talented athletes representing 58 nations have traveled from every angle of the earth all the way to the Nicosia Olympic shooting range to duel it out for the podium. Excitement is buzzing through the tropical air in the anticipation of the results of who can crush the most clays, who can make it to the semifinal, who can make it to the medal matches, and most important, who can make it to the highest step of the podium with the glittery gold is on the minds and in the dreams of the athletes. Who will be the victors and who will be the underdogs? Let's get this show on the road and find out. Yes, that's right. We've made it to the Nicosia Olympic shooting range here in Nicosia, Cyprus, where we're kicking off this week's event with Trap Woman. With gusts of wind tearing through the valley, it's going to be anyone's game. Which one of these talented women are going to end up on the highest step of the podium? Let's tune in and see. After the semifinal, we're moving on to the bronze medal match. Six more shots to go, and Germany's Scheibel is up by two targets. And she nails another. On to the two-time Olympic Games silver medalist. She's back in the game. Five targets to go, and Scheibel still up by two. And that miss is going to eat away at her lead. Stefechikova, who has a signature way of coming from behind and catching up, and another hit for the 2010 world champion. One target between the two, and with four targets to go, anything can happen. Let's focus in again on Scheibel. She's coming off a miss with a hit. Stefechikova is in the zone and nails another. Last three targets to go, and Scheibel still up by one target. The 33-year-old athlete who has never won a World Cup medal before is hungry for the bronze. And she smashes the clay. Back on to the 2011 World Championship silver medalist. She's putting the pressure on Scheibel. We're coming to the end, and Scheibel is still holding on to the lead. And the target flies off untouched. Stefechikova needs this clay to tie up, and it's hers. Scheibel finishes with a hit. If Stefechikova can nail the last clay, we'll be going into a sudden death shoot-off. And she's done it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to determine the bronze with a shoot-off. One hit each, and back onto Scheibel. Another clay crushed. The pressure is back on Stefechikova, and that's one clean clay. Sonia Scheibel has done it, overtaking Stefechikova and winning her very first World Cup medal, the bronze. On to the gold medal match. Two young women going for the highest step of the podium. All scores have been erased, and they will start from zero. Two-time Olympic Games gold medalist Michael Diamond and Italy's coach Albano Pereira focusing in on the situation. Six targets to go, and Skinner down by three. Getting back into the game and nails the clay. On to the one-time World Cup bronze medalist. With such force, you will notice that Stanko is consistent in the way she mounts her shotgun. And she nails it. Still three targets separating Skinner from Stanko with five targets to go. And the clay gets away from her. Back on to 20-year-old Stanko, who has had a banner season. Another target bites the dust. Skinner, who's coming off a miss, and another gets away from her. And she's clearly dismayed. Back onto Stanko. If she can nail this target, the gold will be hers. Last three targets, and Skinner going for the second World Cup silver of the 2013 season. You can see she's finding that hit quite ironic. Stanko starting off with one miss and plowing through her gold medal matches on fire. And she nails another. Skinner. Hop. Finishing off strong. The untouchable Stanko going for her very first World Cup gold medal. Last shot for the 23-year-old athlete. Hop. Finishing off clean and on the second highest step of the podium. Can Stanko finish off with 14 out of 15? Oh. Yes, she can. Silvana Stanko getting a well-deserved hug from Coach Albano Pera. Gold medalist Silvana Stanko will be on the highest step of the podium. It was a very special experience. I wasn't expecting it. I feel wonderful. What can I say? And we're back here at the Nicosia Olympic Games shooting range, where after the trap men's semifinal, the anticipation of who's going to be on the podium is reaching a high. The wind once again gusting up and having a game of its own with the clays. With scores being reset to zero, we're moving on to the bronze medal match between the Czech Republic's Yuri Liptak and the Russian Federation's Alexey Alipov. Six targets to go, and Liptak is coming off his first miss. And he nails it and gets back into the game. On to the 2004 Olympic Games gold medalist, who's shooting a perfect match and is up by one. And he blasts another out of the air. Five targets to go, and Liptak down by one. Oh. And the second clay gets away from him. Alipov, the 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist with a two-target lead, crushes another. Liptak, the 2010 World Championships bronze medalist, coming off a miss with a hit. Back onto Alipov, who's shooting an amazing match. Solid shot for the man who seems untouchable. Three targets to go, and Liptak down by two. Oh. And he smashes the clay. On to the two-time World Championship silver medalist. He nails another. Two more to go for 31-year-old Liptak. Oh. And he smashes it. If the 2006 World Cup final gold medalist can crush this target, the bronze will be his. And he's done it. Last target for Liptak, who put up a good fight. And he finishes off clean and in fourth place. With the bronze already won, let's see if the six-time World Cup gold medalist can finish off shooting a perfect match. And he's done it. Bronze medalist Alexey Alipov, amazing, consistent shooting. One more match to go to see who's going to be on the highest step of the podium between Croatia's Josip Glasnovic and Slovakia's Erik Varga. Both men who shot a fantastic semifinal, 15 out of 15 for Glasnovic and 14 out of 15 for Varga. Six shots to go and Glasnovic down by one. Coming off a hit, with yet another. Varga, who's shooting extremely well with 9 out of 9. And the 10th is floating through the sky untouched. Things are heating up as Glasnovic's door of opportunity is opened. He's gotten into the zone and slams the target squarely. On to the one-time World Cup gold medalist, who's coming off a miss with a hit. Neck to neck and four targets to go. Let's focus in on the 2005 World Championships bronze medalist. It's all his. The pressure's on the one-time World Cup silver medalist. Oof. And he stands up to the pressure and crushes yet another target. We're winding down with three to go. Let's focus in on 30-year-old Glasnovic. Finishing off strong. 36-year-old Varga. Another great shot. With two targets to go and the way these men are shooting, it's quite likely that we'll be going into a sudden death shoot-off. Another fantastic shot for Glasnevich. The pressure's once again on Varga, and it's no problem for him. One more to go and the men are completely tied up. One-time World Cup silver medalist Glasnevich finishes off in style. If Varga can nail this last clay, we'll go into a sudden death shoot-off. And he's done it. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll move ahead with a shoot-off between Glasnevich and Varga. An incredible shoot-off with 12 targets each. And Glasnevich has missed, but he can't let his guard down until he sees what Varga has up his sleeve. It's up to Varga to nail this clay to grab the gold. And he's done it. Erik Varga has won the gold. Fantastic shooting for both these men. And here he is, gold medalist Erik Varga. I'm very happy. This is a great result for me, and I'm really enjoying every moment now. It was a long day today, a very difficult competition with many good shooters around. Winning this World Cup is comparable with winning the World Championships for me. Here we are back at the Nicosia Olympic Shooting Range for the third day of excitement of our time here. And the time for today's medal matches for double trap men is now. After the semifinal, with gusts of wind playing with the clays, we have our finalists for the bronze medal match and the gold medal match. Let's kick it off with the bronze medal match between 26-year-old Mikhail Lebo going up against Pan Kiang. Lebo, the second athlete from the Russian Federation in today's event, nails another double. Pan. He's completely in the zone. With the way Pan is on a roll, it will be extremely difficult for Lebo to make it to the podium today. In fact, if Pan can just get one of these clays, the bronze will be his. And he's done it. Last double for Lebo. Finishing off with a miss and in fourth place. Let's see if Pan can finish off with a perfect score. And he's done it. Pan has shot an unbelievable match and the bronze is his.
So ladies and gentlemen, your bronze medalist representing you and taking fourth place in the competition representing the Russian state.
Let's move it on over to the gold medal match between 38-year-old Emanuele Bernasconi and 41-year-old Vasily Mosin, who shot a perfect 30 out of 30 during the semifinal. Six doubles to go, and Bernasconi down by two. Oh. And he nails the double. On to the 2012 Olympic Games bronze medalist. Another double falls out of the skies. Again, on to one-time World Cup gold medalist. Oh. The clays are his. Mosin, who is apparently on a mission for the gold, crushes the pair. Back on to Bernasconi, still down by two, but shooting strong. Mosin, clearly in the zone with only one miss so far, and he makes it look so easy. Three more doubles to go, and Bernasconi has come back from the hiccup earlier in the match and is finishing off strong. Mosin, proving that he's untouchable, nails another pair. Bernasconi, who's been out of the circuit for some years now, misses the second clay. If the 2005 World Cup final silver medalist can smash this double, the gold will be his. And there you go. Last double for the one-time World Cup bronze medalist, and the silver is his. Back onto the three-time World Cup gold medalist, adding just another gold to his collection. A very content gold medalist, Vasily Mosin.
Финальный матч очень мне понравился.
The gold medal match was perfect, I think.
Вы все видели, только один промах.
I was absolutely satisfied because every shot was centered and centered. This is exactly what we're living for.
Наслаждение не только для стрелка, но и для зрителей.
Good afternoon and welcome to day four here at the Nicosia Olympic Shooting Range, where the winds are howling as the setting sun is appearing and disappearing behind the clouds, and the tension is growing as we settle in for Skeet Woman. After the semifinal, we're moving forward to the medal matches and starting off with the bronze medal match between Italy's Diana Bocossi and Slovakia's golden girl Danka Bartikova. Two more pairs to go and Bocossi has a nice two-target lead.
Oh.
Shooting consistently, Bocossi nails the pair. If she can get the last pair, the bronze medal will be hers.
Oh.
And she does it. Bocossi will be on the podium today. Bartikova, the 2012 World Cup final gold medalist, has no chance for the podium, but let's see how she finishes up on station four. Nice solid shots and two more to go.
Dai.
And she finishes off clean and in fourth place. Here she is, bronze medalist Diana Bocossi from Italy, winning her second World Cup medal of the 2013 season. Let's move it over to the gold medal match between Chang Donglian from the People's Republic of China and Andrei Eliferiou from Cyprus. On to Chang, currently tied up with Eliferiou. She crushes the regular pair. Two more to go for the 2011 World Cup final bronze medalist. And finishes up with 13 out of 16. The pressure's on the 2008 World Cup final gold medalist. The fans in the stands are counting on her. One more pair, and if the one-time World Cup gold medalist can crush them, we'll be going into a sudden-death shoot-off. And she's done it. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be going on to a shoot-off for the gold. 5 out of 6 for the one-time World Cup gold medalist.
Huh?
On to Eliferiou. The pressure's on her shoulders as she's shooting on her home turf. And one gets away from her, but the silver is hers. Gold medalist Chang Donglian from the People's Republic of China. And we're back to the last event of our time here at the Nicosia Olympic Games Shooting Range, where we'll wind things up with Skeet Men. With the winds gusting up and then coming to a complete halt, the scores after the semifinal going back down to zero, it'll be anyone's game for the medal matches. Let's move it on over to the bronze medal match between Ephimeos Mitas from Greece and Juan Jose Aramburu from Spain. Let's focus in on the fifth station and Mitas, who's shooting a fantastic match. He's cleared the regular pair and now onto the reverse for the one-time World Cup gold medalist. And he's done it. On to the 2011 world champion, who's been in the zone with a perfect 8 out of 8. Aramburu crushes the regular pair. Now onto the reverse for the 2011 World Cup final bronze medalist. And he makes it look so easy. Back to station 4 for the one-time World Cup silver medalist. And the low house target flies away. This could cost him dearly. Last pair for Mitas. He slams them squarely, but with that miss, he's opened the door of opportunity for Aramburu. The pressure's on the one-time World Cup bronze medalist. If he can get the last pair, the bronze will be his. And he's done it. Juan Jose Aramburu will be on the podium today. Great sportsmanship between Mitas and Aramburu. Bronze medalist, Juan Jose Aramburu.
And also congratulations, taking fourth place in this competition, representing Greece, Kyrgios Mitas.
Let's focus in now on the gold medal match between Abdullah Al-Rashidi from Kuwait and Henrik Janssen from Sweden. The three-time world champion coming off a miss with a perfect pair. The last time Al-Rashidi was on the highest step of the podium was 16 years ago. And another pair is his. On to Janssen, who has never entered into a final round of a World Cup before and is shooting strong. He nails the regular pair. Now let's see the reversed.
Go.
And they both get away from him. This is going to change his standings, giving Al-Rashidi the upper hand. On to the last station for the two-time World Cup gold medalist, who's up by one. And with his signature speedy shooting, nails the pair. If Al-Rashidi can finish off clean, the gold will be his. And the high house target gets away from him. Last two pairs for Janssen. He just has to get back into the zone and hammer out these two pairs to go into a sudden death shoot-off with Al-Rashidi. And the regular pair is his. Just two more to go for Janssen, who seems quite confident. And he's done it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going off to a shoot-off for the gold. Al-Rashidi and Janssen are neck to neck, 8-8. And the two-time World Cup silver medalist does it again. On to Janssen, the pressure's on his shoulders to clear another pair. And one gets away, leaving him with the silver. 16 years later, Abdullah Al-Rashidi makes his way back to the highest step of the podium, winning the gold. Since 16 years ago, I've been trying to get back on the podium, but familiar problems, some problems with my family, with business, and some obligations didn't let me concentrate. But now I can concentrate, and I have repeated what I did 16 years ago, and I'm on the podium again. And that wraps up the excitement of the third leg of the ISSF World Cup in Shotgun. Come and join us at the beginning of July, where we'll make our way to Granada, Spain, the last stage of the 2013 World Cup season. Until then, shooting fans,